Overnight, President Trump in Minnesota awarding himself high marks for his combative and chaotic debate performance.
We, all of us, won big last night. And I don't know, did you hear about this? In the history of cable television, had the highest ratings of any show in the history of cable television.
The president earlier trying to clean up after refusing to condemn white supremacists.
I'm willing to do anything. I
want
to see peace.
Then do it, sir.
Do you want to call him? What do you want to call him? Give me a name.
White supremacists and
right like me to condemn?
White supremacists and right
Proud Boys. Stand back and stand by.
The Proud Boys, a far-right extremist group celebrating the president's remarks. President Trump is now distancing himself from the group.
I don't know who the Proud Boys are. I mean, you'll have to give me a definition because I really don't know who they are. I can only say they have to stand down, let law enforcement do their work.
Joe Biden not mincing words.
My message to the Proud Boys and every other white supremacist group is cease and desist. That's not who we are. This is not who we are as Americans.
The presidential pushback was swift and bipartisan. This from the Senate's lone black Republican, Tim Scott.
I think he misspoke. I think he should correct it. If he doesn't correct it, I guess he didn't misspeak.
Trailing in the polls, even President Trump's allies worry he did not gain any new voters.
I think he missed the opportunity to brag on some of the real accomplishments.
Instead, spending the debate heckling and taunting his rival.
Don't ever use the word smart with me. Don't ever use that word.
Why would you answer that question?
Biden riding the rails through Ohio and Pennsylvania denouncing the president's behavior.
I think it was just a national embarrassment.
In Ohio, some undecided voters telling NBC's Kate Snow they were turned off by the entire episode.
I felt as embarrassed as an American, honestly.
Well, Peter, the debate commission has been under a tremendous pressure to make some kind of changes. What's the plan?
Yeah, no, Savannah, you're right. The Commission on Presidential Debates says that it will make changes for this year's remaining matchups, posting a statement saying additional structure should be added to ensure a more orderly discussion of the issues. Those are their words. A source close to the committee telling me among the changes being considered, cutting off a candidate's microphone if they violate the rules. Important to note that no final decision has been made yet. As for the ratings from this week, 73 million Americans watched Tuesday's showdown on TV. That is the second highest viewership ever for a first presidential debate. But the number is down from 4 years ago when Mr. Trump faced off against Hillary Clinton.